welcome back to Dina Cruising Through Life. I hope you're having an amazing day. Sorry about my passport wall. It will get some love eventually as I continue to build this room up. Then you'll be able to have something inspiring behind me, right? So for now, I'm going to give you my cruise updates. Is in December 2019 on the Carnival Imagination. And that one is a family cruise, planning it by that time almost 2 years. And so this is my grandkids' kind of Christmas gift. So it's my 8 grandkids, my 2 of my children, 2 their spouses, my brother and his friend slash roommate slash caretaker. He's kind of a little of everything. And so they have a handicap accessible room. So I'm gonna be able to show you what that looks like on the Carnival Imagination. Everyone else, we all have inside cabins. I think I have an ocean view room. And so I'm super excited about this. And so this is all of theirs. First cruise. So this is going to be like good luck to me, right? So I'm gonna get a lot of opinions, a lot of feedback, and so, but it's also kind of good because I know this is what I love, and but it's kind of good to see what their perspective is. And if they like it, then they know that they could go on like a longer cruise, different ship or whatever. So anyway, my grandkids by that time, let's see, the youngest will be almost 2 and the oldest will be 13. So I'm gonna get a good array of opinions from these kids regarding the food, the activities, the entertainment, and maybe hopefully they're not, I don't wanna hear they're bored. So I'm hoping that this ship keeps them busy and active and fun. So anyway, so I'm excited about that. About a month later, I'm getting on the Carnival Panorama. Now, this may be a little bit of a change, so I will actually believe I'm actually going to make this change. I'm pretty positive. I'm like 99.9%. So I've definitely got another video for this, which is I want to change my cabin. So originally I was going, there was going to be 2 of us in the room. And so now I'm going solo. And so I just don't feel like spending an extra like $600 on a cabin, which balcony's lovely. And it was a cove balcony. So I was really excited to be able to see one and have one of those. But it's a savings of $600 if I change to an interior. So I'm gonna be working on that and bringing you back that information of how I do that. And so I just think it's a good savings, right? I can use that elsewhere. So that is in January, and that's to Cabo, Mazatlan, Puerto Vallarta. Most people know that the Mexican Riviera, and that's going to be the Panorama 7-day itinerary since it's coming directly to the West Coast. So yay. I'm excited about that. I've done that itinerary before, so, but it's going to be definitely exciting to be on a brand, pretty much a brand new ship within just a few weeks. So I'm excited. So next thing is March. So this is the tricky part. March and the end of May. I have options. Well, I'm going to be taking some vacation during those times. My biggest thing is trying to figure out what I'm going to do during those 2 months. I want to take about 2 weeks off in May. But my option is to look more at May right now and to figure out if I want to do another Mediterranean and vacation. Which I was really looking at the Carnival Radiance, which is a 12-day itinerary. I think it's 10. No, it's 12. It is 12. I'm pretty sure that one's 12. And so I'm heavily looking at that particular itinerary for that time frame. However, if I see that I'm not going to get all I can out of my budget because I know the radiance is coming over here, then it's not like a ship that I have to go over there to go on. Then I'm thinking I may consider doing a back to back in maybe out of Florida or whatever, and in May. So like a back to back cruises, maybe not the same ship, maybe it's just two different cruises. Not sure yet. So those are my two options. So once I identify what I'm going to do in May, that's going to determine what I do in March. I'm basically going to do the opposite. But if it's going to Europe in March, if that's the end decision, it'll be a land vacation. So I will book probably the same Airbnb I stayed at near the Vatican when I went, because I really liked it. I know it, know the neighborhood, know the restaurants, I know where the bus is, I know the train is, I got it. So I think I would do like a land vacation for like a few days, a week or whatever. If it ends up being I go do the Mediterranean longer cruise in May, then I will do a Caribbean cruise in March. So May is the big factor there of what I will be doing. And it's all based on flights and how much the cruises are and everything. So I really do look and see what that's going to entail. And I'll break that down and I'll bring that planning process to you. So let's see, the next thing that I have planned is I'm already booked on for the October 2020 group cruise with the Lalita Loca Sharon at Sea group. And so I'm already booked on that, and I have a balcony with that one. So I'll be going on that cruise. And then, so the only other things that I haven't planned out, which I may throw in here and there, so, and I haven't quite decided. I really would love to do an Alaska cruise, but I don't know if my vacation time will allow, but we shall see if I end up able to do that. So we will find out. And it would probably be August or something. So we'll see. We'll see. We'll see. We'll see. I think that is it. That is all I'm going to do for next year. I don't know. That's, and I also have like work vacations too. In February, I travel for work to Chicago, and in March, I travel for work to Vegas. A short trip to Vegas. So, and I'm not really a Vegas type person. Like, I don't gamble and, you know, anyway, it's like, it's very rare. And so, anyways, I may just like go and do like the one day and then hit the road. I know that doesn't appeal to most people, but a lot of people like to gamble. So they're like, conference in Vegas? Yeah, I'm going. But yeah, I don't really, it doesn't appeal to me. But connecting with these individuals is awesome. So that's the reason I would go. Oh, anyway, I think that is it. So basically, travel in December, January, February for work, March for work, end of March for personal, for it'll either be land or Caribbean. And end of May for sure, I'll definitely be going. And then for sure in October on the group cruise. And then hopefully I can squeeze in one other, but we shall see. So that is it for now. If you have any other questions, you can leave a comment below. If you have any questions, tell me where you're going. Just tell me. Let me know where you're going, what your plans are. Do you really plan as much as I do, or do you plan like one a year? Do you plan 12 a year? I mean, tell me what you do. Tell me what your process is. Do you follow a budget too? Or do you just like say, okay, I'm gonna save all year and I'm gonna really like go wild? So just let me know. Leave a comment below. And if you like this video, give it a little like. and share it. Follow me on, I don't know, follow me on Instagram. Sure, follow me on Instagram if you want. I kind of give like some dailies up there. I haven't been doing it as much. I really shouldn't say that. But anyway, take care and have a great day.